It was just after sunset in summer of 2014. I was traveling on a remote road in the Cuyahoga Valley National Park near Brecksville, Ohio. It's close to the Akron/Cleveland area. I had gotten off work early and decided to head home before the evening rush. As I was driving through the park, I noticed movement alongside the road. It looked like a deer grazing along the side. I slowed down as I approached it. I love hunting, but I also love seeing them. What I saw that day, though, was nothing like a deer. I stopped my car to get a closer look, because it looked different than a deer. It was leaning against a tree. I was about 20 yards away from it. When I first saw it, I was awestruck by how large it was, easily over 6 to 7 feet tall. But I couldn't tell its color due to the dark. It just kind of looked like a large shadow, which is why I originally thought it was a deer, but as I looked closer, I thought it might be a person in a ghillie suit. That made no sense, though, because it was in the middle of nowhere, and there was a no-hunting rule, so I was perplexed. I got out of my car to investigate further. As I walked closer, I noticed a foul smell in the air. It was a mix of vomit and excrement. I assumed maybe it was a dead deer nearby, or something, and it was dark. I shined my light on this animal, and it appeared to be actually eating a dead deer, ripping deer into pieces. I could not see the head of the deer, and I quickly recognized that this wasn't a dog or anything else. It was not a bear or a deer. I was filled with fear. What I saw was reminiscent to that of a werewolf. I ran back to my car and gunned it. I never looked back. I've done my research, and one theory is that it's a wendigo. I don't know about that, though. I do know that it was not a dog, bear, deer, or certainly it was not a person. I was at work one day in the late fall. It was 1995, at a national park in the state of Washington. The name will be redacted for the story. It was late morning, around 11. The weather was overcast, around 50 or 60 degrees. There wasn't much wind. Work was slow that day, and I was alone in the tower, monitoring the parking lots of the trailheads. It would be nice to have some distraction, so I decided to radio down to the other rangers at the visitor center, ask them if they wanted to come up to the tower with me. Most just said they would be as soon as they were available. At this point, I decided to just continue my slow patrols of the parking lots, hoping I would run into somebody I could talk to them. I went to the northmost parking lot and began walking slowly down the road that ran behind the lot. As I walked, I looked around for cars that looked like they had been parked for a while, and trash in the parking lot. As I reached the end, I noticed something on the other side of the road. It was standing just left of the road, maybe 50 yards away. I stopped and looked at it, thinking it might be a person that was just getting out of their car, but it didn't move. So I assumed it was a person until I got a better look. I started walking towards it, thinking it may have just been somebody. As I got closer, it just stood there, frozen, and then was facing me. It kept its head moving back and forth, like it was looking around, and I realized this was not a person at all. It was at least 8 feet tall, covered in brown fur that was very long, kind of like that of a sheep or a bear. But the head was white, with a pointy snout, big round eyes that did not seem to have any visible eyelids. Its arms were like human, but they seemed very long and had a lot of muscle and definition to them, even with all the fur. It was standing on two legs, like an upright person would, but kind of leaning forward, on its hands almost. It had a flatter face, at least beside the snout. I noticed that it didn't have any teeth, at least that I saw. I'm not sure what I was looking at. It was very strange. But the most strange thing was its lower body. It kind of resembled more like that of a kangaroo, because of how its legs were bent backwards towards its butt. I kept thinking to myself, I'm either going crazy, or somebody is in a very elaborate costume. The more I kept staring at it, I realized that it must be somebody playing a joke, but it looked far too realistic. I was scared at this point, and I just stood there looking at it, trying to figure out what it was and what to do. It then looked back at me exactly, and I heard a voice. It was one of the other rangers that I had called earlier. He was asking me what I was doing, and I told him I had found something out in the far parking lot and wanted him to come take a look. It was then that I heard its voice. It was almost telepathically. It was kind of like a growling sound, but more like a series of sounds that sounded more like a language than just a growl. I don't know how to explain it, but it was the most terrifying thing I've ever heard. I turned around and started walking as fast as I could back to the tower. I was halfway there when I looked back and saw this thing was following me. I made it to the tower and got up as fast as I could. It was still standing now in the parking lot. Now, I thought it might try and climb over the fence, but it did not. I looked back several times. It never crossed the road. One of the other rangers came up about a half hour later. I told him what I saw. I had asked him to go out there with me, but he refused. I called the other rangers from other parks. They wouldn't come out either. Even though they laughed at me, I still think part of them believed. I never saw it again after this, but I don't think I could ever face it again. I even told my wife about it. She thought I was crazy and does not believe me. I'm not crazy. I do not know what that thing was, but I know I saw it. I work the night shift as a park ranger, and I patrol a state park in the south part of the United States. I'm not saying which park. I've been employed as a ranger for 9 years, and have worked as a lead ranger at several parks. I'm also an avid hiker, and have experienced many of the natural wonders this country has to offer. Also, I had the fortune of having witnessed the supernatural a few times during my career. Once while I was hiking with my family in the early summer, but the other while alone hiking in the winter. Both times in a similar park that I'm currently employed at. But I digress. Let me tell you about what happened to me. It was a few weeks ago. I was working on the night shift. My partner had already come in and gotten off work, so I was all alone. I was patrolling the trails and the grounds, as was my usual routine. I had just finished patrolling the main trails and had moved on to the smaller trails, located farther out of the main area of the park. I was in the gorge area of the park, named for its narrow winding trails that lead from the top of the mountain to the bottom. While making my way down to the trail to the bottom, I began to hear an odd noise coming from behind. I could not quite make out what it was at first, but it sounded like a scuffling noise. It was a small trail, and I turned around to see if I can get a look at what was making the noise. I looked behind me, and due to the darkness, could not see anything. I returned down to the walking trail, and the noise again sounded from behind me. I again turned around, and this time I saw it. A black shadow-like figure walking upright on the trail, parallel to me. I was startled by the sight of the figure, and turned around to continue on my way. The noise was again heard behind me, so I turned to get a better look. The figure was still there, but had moved, even with me. I could not make out any face or feature of this figure. It was entirely black, no shadows or even staining. I again turned away and began walking in the trail, doing my best to ignore it. The noise again happened behind me, so I turned once more. It was still there, but I could make out this sort of strange figure. However, right near where the shadow was, I saw a separate figure. This one, pale and gray, where I could see its face and make out a few features. It was very disturbing. It looked strange. The skin was a pale gray, and the features looked similar to those of a human, but very strange. The mouth was open, and the figure appeared to be making a moaning noise. I stood there staring at this thing for a few seconds, with the black shadow figure coming up behind me. It then continued to turn, coming down my way. It was no longer standing. It was now crouched down, and turned its head to look at me. The gray figure in the trees turned away and disappeared. I knew I was in danger from whatever was happening to me, from the shadowy figure that was following me to the gray humanoid figure watching me through the trees. Something was going on, and I knew if I did not exit now, my life was in danger. I quickly turned around and made my way back, unaware that this thing might still be following me. After all, I have no idea what it was I encountered. could have been paranormal, could have been alien. I'm not sure. I'm sorry my story is so short, but I really am not a good storyteller. So, I'll let you summarize this for me. Maybe you can give me some answers as to what I saw, and why I was being followed. By what? I've been working now as a ranger for roughly 7 years. I can say that I generally love my career choice, however, sometimes you have to deal with things that are a little unorthodox. Besides that, it's a pretty normal career, and if you're an outdoorsy person like I am, it can be a lot of fun. Besides all of that, I'm going to tell you about a sighting I had back in the spring of 2015 of what I thought was a large humanoid reptilian creature. I had parked my work truck at the back of our visitor center parking lot, walking to the back of the lot, to the edge of the woods. I noticed there was a small stream that was flowing down the hillside. I was going to see if I can get a closer look and possibly see some wildlife. It was about 10 p.m., but it was a pretty dark, clear night. The moon was not up that night, and the only light I had was from a very dim light from the back of the visitor center, and from my flashlight. I stood there for a few moments, beginning to play with my flashlight, shining it randomly all throughout the woods. I looked down, and saw that in the stream, there was a flat rock that I could use to cross. As I was about halfway across, I heard rustling of something large. The first thought that crossed my mind was a deer, so I froze and listened. The rustling began to get closer and closer, and turned into a loud crashing through the trees, and I had a distinct feeling that whatever it was heading towards me. So I spun around and began to shine my light. There was nothing there, nothing that I could visibly see. I felt like I was being watched, like this thing was standing there just beyond the line of light, silently observing me. And at one point or another, I could see faintly glowing yellow eyes staring back at me, with slits in them, like a large lizard. Fear overtook my entire body, and I knew in that moment I had to get out of there now, retreating back to the lot. I've only ever heard other stories of similar sightings from other park rangers in other states, so who knows? Maybe it wasn't a reptilian creature, maybe it was. Either way, it still really scared me. I just figured I'd wanted to share my encounter with you. My wife and I were avid hikers. This was in 2008, a time where we had just got married and I was in the full height of my park ranger career. We loved the Rocky Mountains. We had also gotten a job in Colorado, so we ended up moving out here to Colorado. We decided to go on a hike on one of our first days here. We went to this place called the Devil's Head Rock Climbing Area, very close to Breckenridge, Colorado. We had gone there and hiked. On our way back, it was just before dusk. We were walking back to the car, and I was looking across the valley that we were currently in. I saw something. It was about a mile away. I thought I was seeing things, so I called my wife over, and I was pointing to this thing that I was seeing. She saw it too. We both saw it. It was dark, maybe 6'3", tall and skinny. It had scales on its face, and a very elongated face, a very long thin neck. It was walking on its hind legs, like a human, but walking across the valley, kind of in a jogging motion, just for a few moments. It disappeared into the woods and was gone. It was almost like it did not want us to follow it. At the time, we thought it was maybe a deer, but we realized deer don't look like this or move like this. It had the features of a wendigo. What else could it be? Thanks for your time and take care. I pretty much grew up in the park system and was a ranger for 10 years in a row, from the ages of 18 to 28. I am now married and have 2 children, also having a degree in forest management. I know the parks of our nation like the back of my hand. I have worked at every job in the park, including maintenance, construction, enforcement, office duties, and, of course, management. I consider myself an expert in the outdoors, wilderness survival techniques, and tracking. I'm pretty familiar with all the animal, plant, and insect species within the park. I'm also an expert in wildlife, and a keen observer. I have hiked and camped in the park for years, so I'm very familiar with all the legends and stories people talk about. However, over the years, I've been assigned to work in the mountains and forests of the parks. I was a backcountry ranger and a mountain ranger for several years as well. I've hiked, climbed, and camped almost every day. So, back in 1997, I was a mountain ranger at the Grand Canyon. My job was to patrol the south rim from the Desert View area to the South Kaibab trailhead at the bottom of the canyon. I was patrolling the area from the Hoppy House to the edge of the forest at the top of the rim. The south rim is roughly 10 miles long, and I was assigned to cover the area from the house to the forest. This is an area of roughly 100 square miles of forest and rim. I was on foot and had to hike between two points. A backcountry patrol is usually a three-day patrol. I would hike in, spend the night, and hike out. I had a map, a compass, and everything else needed for navigation, and a radio for communication with the rangers at the Grand Canyon Lodge. At the time, the park had radio repeaters at the top and bottom of the rim, so you could talk from the top to the bottom of the canyon. The conversation was by radio repeater, and was a continual transmission. If you were up high, you could talk and hear, but if you were down low, you could not hear and talk. The repeater was mounted on the highest part of the rim to ensure the best coverage. The repeater was about up to 20 feet up a tree. I was hiking up the trail by the Grand Canyon Lodge. The weather was warm and sunny. The forest was brimming with wildlife. I was walking down the trail and I had my radio in hand with my walkie-talkie radio to my ear. I was listening to the radio chatter and at this point, I noticed something large up in a tree that what I first thought was a crow. At first glance, I assumed it was a crow, but the size was wrong. The sighting was brief and lasted maybe a second or two because I thought, what the heck is that thing? I looked at the tree and the crow or whatever it was, and it made a quick but large flight from the top of the tree to the bottom. I had a weird feeling about it. I'm very familiar with the animal, insect, and bird species of this forest, but the animals in this forest have a set of tracks and signs that are unique. This, however, was much different. This was not a crow, but an animal that flew similar to a crow. And I kept thinking, what am I watching? What is this being? This bird was not a normal-sized bird, and I have never seen a blackbird as big as this in my life. Easily larger than a condor. I kept hiking up the trail, eventually making it to the top of the rim. I stayed up there as long as possible and began to hike down the trail to the bottom of the canyon. The trail down to the bottom of the canyon is a very long and difficult hike. I hiked down several miles in a very long day. There were people ahead of me and several people behind me hiking down the trail. There should have been hikers all over though that day. I always wonder if that creature had something to do with the lack of hikers that day, because there weren't near as many as there should have been. I was a park ranger at the Lake Roosevelt National Recreation Area here in Washington State. This park is, I believe, to be the largest in the state, or at least it used to be. My station was in the middle of virtually nowhere. It was our job to patrol the entire park, keeping people out of closed hazardous zones, checking to see if any campsites were occupied, look for campfires, and make sure everybody was obeying all the proper rules. About a mile and a half up the road from my station, there was this rutted dirt road that led to a closed-off area. It was partially my job to drive up and down this road, make sure nobody had gone on there and stayed off it. Anyway, a lot of times, we'd sometimes find wayfaring park visitors camped in this closed area, which is kind of funny because it had a really creepy vibe to it. One day, I was driving up this road, and I couldn't shake this uneasy feeling I had. It was like we were being watched. I was uneasy the previous day, too. Two other members of the U.S. Forest Service had been attacked by a black bear, apparently. It was the only black bear that had been seen in this area for years, so the officials were worried that I was going to be ill or injured. Anyway, I was driving up this road, the only person in the vehicle, so I had my windows down and did not have my radio on. I was listening for sounds. I heard a snap, and then a swishing sound, like something big was running through the bush. I saw movement from the corner of my eyes, and I saw a man running into the road and run into the forest on the other side. And I realized it was a man, but it wasn't a man. This human was naked, had pale white skin, skinny and looked very malnourished. It had crazy stringy hair on its head, and it hung down to its neck. His or its eyes were crazy. They were red and bulging out of its head like an insect. He or it ran in front of my car, and I nearly hit it. It didn't look at me. It was intent on running into the forest. He was looking up at the trees, and which made me think he was looking at whatever the hell scared him. I drove up to where he had run into the forest, but I did not see him. I got out of my car, called out to him, asking if he was all right. I heard no answer, and then I saw him, crouching down behind a tree, hiding. I decided that I needed to leave him alone. I drove back to my station and told the other rangers about it. Nobody took me seriously. I don't know why I didn't do anything more, but I just had this bad feeling in the pit of my gut that screamed danger, that I should not approach him or do anything to him, and if I did, I would be in a whole heaping world of trouble. It's probably a good thing I left him alone. A few weeks later, I saw one of the rangers who had been in the forest, and I asked him if he had seen what I had seen. Apparently, there had been other people in the area who'd reported seeing the same thing I did. A strange, pale, naked man, bulging red eyes, pale, rotting skin, running. I'm not exactly sure what to make of it myself. Maybe it's a drug addict, maybe it's a mentally ill person, maybe it's not even human. I haven't seen anything weird like this since, but every so often, it makes me wonder if there's something more to the world than what we know. I was a ranger in St. Louis County, Minnesota. The year was 2007. A man on our staff went missing during his lunch break. He was a husband and father. We sent a search party out to locate him. We searched the area for about a day or so, but he was nowhere to be found. We even made inquiries to other nearby towns, but they had no information. We assumed he had wandered away from the area and may have perished. The family of this man requested his remains be found and buried. We honored this request. We had several months go by, and we put this man behind us. Then a strange occurrence happened. One early evening, in the fall, I was out on patrol, running radar on the roads. I was about 2 miles north of town, which is a rural area. I was doing my rounds, and I spotted a pair of eyes in the ditch. I thought it was a fox or a coon. I stopped my vehicle, stepped out. I wasn't expecting what I saw next. A dark, shadowy figure became now visible. It was hunched over, finishing off a deer. This deer was a simple 4-point buck. The thing had just been killed and was eating it. That's not all. I was shocked at what followed. It stood back up, this thing on 2 legs, walking upright. It looked me in the eyes, and quickly, it disappeared. The eyes were blood red. I watched this thing walk off into a nearby creek and disappeared. Immediately, I went back to the office, and called my boss and told him what I saw. He told me to stay there until he could get there. So I sat there, staying in the office, while my boss and another ranger wrote down everything they could about what I had to say. They searched for a few hours, but could not find anything. I was scared to go out on patrol the next few days. It only happened one or two more times after this, and even then, that's probably too much. I ended up seeing it again in the area where I first saw it. It never acted aggressive, but it was always in that area. The final time, it was winter, and there was about 12 inches of snow on the ground. I saw it again. This was the last time. I was relieved when the spring came, and I did not have to patrol that section any longer. Now, before I end my story, let me quickly tell you why I included the first part about the man missing after lunch. I believe that his spirit became disembodied and turned into this horrible, ghastly apparition that I saw, or otherwise known as a Wendigo. I believe that it's possible that his spirit, or him dying, turned into this creature that I saw. Of course, this is just a wild theory, but I cling to it because it makes sense to me. I would love to hear any comments or thoughts, or even theories, on what they think. Do you believe that he turned into a Wendigo? Is it possible that he died, and his spirit was able to manifest as this being? I don't know. I work for the forest service industry. I work primarily in the Pacific Northwest, but I've also worked in the Rocky Mountains in the Northeast. I've also been to the Grand Canyon, Big Bend, Yosemite, just to name a few. I've been a full-time for almost 3 years now, and I do a lot of things that people enjoy doing. My job is a lot of fun, but can also be very dangerous. My job basically is to enforce park regulations and ensure the safety of visitors and the resources. I'm basically like a security guard for a huge chunk of land, and it's my job to deal with bad guys and make sure people have a good time. If a park is crowded, I may do a lot of crowd control and incident management, which can be fun or boring depending on the people. I usually only deal with an individual, but sometimes deal with groups. This alone can be pretty frustrating. One day, I was called to a private hiking trail in the dark. I'm still not sure why. All I know is that I was called in because apparently there was a group of hikers who were causing trouble on the trail, and I had to deal with them. I will call the hikers the group, and the trail I believe to be called Fox Trail. It's a private hiking trail that is inaccessible during winter months. It was a long hike from the parking lot to the trail. I got called out here in the middle of the night because this group was apparently vandalizing and even knocking over and destroying trail markers. I was told by my regional office that I would just have to deal with the group. It should be easy. I was told that apparently it was a few teenage boys, and they should be fine if I escorted them out of the park and left them out with any fines. Anyway, I set off looking. The trail was a long hike, and it would be a very long hike. A few hours later, I had my flashlight and my radio. The night was cold and quiet. I got to the trail and found the group's vehicle. I knocked on it, called them on the radio, but nobody responded. Then I got on the radio and called the regional office. The rangers who were working on the other side of the park were going to send somebody out to help. I had to wait a few moments, so I decided to check the trail. I put on my headlamp and began. The trail was narrow, and the footing could be tricky. I was a little worried about one of the group members falling down the mountain and getting hurt. Search and rescue is not fun to be a part of. I decided to go slow, so I could make sure nobody got hurt. It was pretty dark, and visibility was very poor. I could see the trail, and I could see all the trees around me. But other than that, I could not see very far. Now at this point, I was about a mile down the trail when I heard something. It was a little far off, but it sounded like someone was throwing rocks at the side of the mountain. I stopped for a moment and listened. It sounded like something big was throwing rocks, and the sound seemed to be trailing up to my left. I stopped. It sounded like somebody was screaming or yelling, but it sounded distorted. I also made sure my radio was turned up, so I could hear just in case somebody was trying to get a hold of me. I decided to quickly move down the trail, going somewhat slow and cautious. I did not want to trip over anybody or anything. I was about a mile and a half down the trail now, when my radio burst alive. It was the regional office. They were saying that they had rangers coming out to help me, but they were having some issues, and that it would be a little while longer than they thought. Now, as I rounded a small bend, the sound of rock throwing and yelling got even louder. I almost turned back when I heard something that scared me. There was something there, standing just off the trail in the trees. Its arm was out, big enough that I could see there was a hand. The hand looked human, minus the fact of its size and ugly shape and color. I was only about 5 meters from this thing. I'm not really scared of people for the record, but I've been in a few altercations with animals. This thing looked human, but I don't think it was. Its shoulder and body looked weird, and it almost appeared to be wearing an old medieval-style robe. There was a hood hanging over its head, and when I shone my light in its face, what I saw terrified me. It, his, or her, I don't know what you would refer to it as, The skin was gray and dead-looking, the eyes black, and the mouth full of these little pin-tack teeth. Strategically thinking, I figured my best course of action was to now quickly turn around and make my way back towards the vehicle that I came from. As frightened as I was, I knew if I made a sound, this being or person or thing would get me, or so that's what I felt. So I turned around, made it a few more feet, and turned back around. The movement of whatever that thing was watching me was now gone, but I could have swore that I faintly saw a shape moving in the brush towards my direction. So I turned back facing the trail, moving quickly back the way I came. And I'm almost certain the entire way back to my vehicle, it followed me, whatever they were. Once I was able to reach regional office and talk to them, I explained to them what my experiences were, and that I never found the group. They partly laughed at me, partly told me it was probably just somebody out there watching me. But I'm telling you now, what I saw was not human, and I really have no way to explain it away, even to this day. So I'm contacting you and hoping you can help me here. I work in the Minnesota National Park System as a ranger. I've been a park ranger here for the past few years, and have been to many remote places in the park system. Plenty of backcountry camping experiences, and plenty of wildlife experience, and plenty of night experiences. I am very familiar with the wilderness and the animals that occupy it. I am also familiar with the Native American culture and legends of the Native Americans. So, I am very familiar with the different creatures the natives call skinwalkers. One night, I was camping out in the backcountry of Buckhorn State Park. There are many campgrounds here in the park, but I like to camp out in the backcountry. There are lots of trails to hike on, lots of lakes around to explore. I was camping in the middle of the forest, right near the lake. I had hiked around the lake earlier that day and seen a lot of deer, foxes, beavers, you name it. Seeing a lot of wildlife is a good sign. So I had been camping now for a few hours. It was nighttime. I had a fire going and was relaxing. I heard the beaver in the lake, the owls, and the usual scurrying of animals. At about 11 p.m., the forest got really quiet. I decided to try and lie down and go to sleep. I'd been sleeping in my truck, but I felt safer in a tent. When I was in my tent, I heard this owl, one owl, hooting in a very strange way. It didn't sound like a normal owl, it sounded more like a howl or a yell almost, like a human voice intermixed. I was confused that it was just one owl. I never heard an owl make such a noise before. I was curious and also kind of frightened, so I stayed awake. I would hear the noise all intermittently throughout the night, just past the lake. I never heard an owl that close to me either. It appeared like it kept getting closer, which I also thought was rather odd. Then, at about 1 a.m., I heard it again as well, and this time, it was very close by, maybe 100 yards away from my tent. So curiously, I shined my flashlight around but could not see anything. The next time I heard the owl, it was closer. There was no other noises. The night was eerily silent. I was confused. I was scared. Now, it was about 1:30, and I was very tired and also scared. I heard the owl now on the other side of the lake. I kept shining my light around but could not see anything. After some time, I just finally decided to give up and decided that that was enough. So I went back in my tent and lay down and forced myself to go to sleep. I woke up early to the sun shining in my face. As I got out of my tent, I noticed the forest was still quiet, and I noticed something else very disturbing. Maybe no more than 30 yards away from my campsite, specifically my tent, were these large bipedal tracks. The only problem is they were not shoe or feet prints. They were large prints of a coyote, it appeared to be, and they moved from here, around my tent, to the lake, where they just seemed to stop. Not to the shore, to the lake, but just stopped. I wasn't exactly sure what I should make of it. After returning back, I had heard some other stories about finding mutilated deer all around that same area, and other people talking about hearing owls hooting and being strange screaming voices. almost like it's part animal, part human. All these stories centered around Buckhorn State Park. Now, not only am I left confused, but also scared, because I believe that possibly I encountered a shapeshifter, or a skinwalker, something of Native American legend. Although, I can't be 100% certain. I feel like I have enough proof to back me up on this. Not my story, but actually a friend of mine, who's a ranger, also a fisherman, and has been in the woods, lakes, and mountains of the Northwest since he was at least 5 or 6. He is an expert tracker and woodsman, and lifelong outdoorsman. He's never really been scared of anything in the woods. He is an expert with a sidearm, and also prides himself in having a black belt and Aikido. He has no fear or hesitation about any situation, especially in the woods. But he has seen some weird stuff, but nothing to make him hesitate, let alone fear. So, this is a story he told me and has given me full permission to share it with you. One day, late afternoon, he was on a solo campout in the Cascade foothills, about an hour's or so drive from Seattle. He had been fishing a favorite creek, then hiking clear around the base of a tall mountain, then back to his camp. It was late afternoon. The light was beginning to fade and he was starting to get ready to cook his dinner. He heard a noise off to his left, on a game trail that went down to the side of the mountain and back to a creek. He turned around and saw a large hairy biped walking on 2 legs, moving quickly away from him down the trail. He could see that it was making a deep rumbling noise, almost like it had a cold or a really bad wet sinus cough, as he described it. It had long or dark brown black hair and was huge, easily 7 feet tall if not larger, and very wide shoulders, big arms and long legs. He claims it did not look like a bear, but it did look like a big hairy giant ape. But he said it moved quickly off, and he never saw it, at least that fully, again. He thought it was a bear until later. When he was making camp, he found a young doe carcass, but the carcass was ripped apart. No real blood on the carcass or the ground. He said it reminded him of a grizzly kill, but the legs were twisted backwards. He said it looked like a bear kill, but that it looked like something had twisted the legs to change the way the deer's body was positioned. It disturbed him. The kill was also fresh, and no more than a day or two old. He had a small fire going, and it was now getting dark. He had his pistol out and was looking around. Then he almost heard a thwop noise behind him. He turned around and sees these big dark red eyes, like cat's eyes, in the tree above his head. He said it looked like the eyes were on a large scale, like the way a bird's eyes are, but it was red, not yellow. He said it was more similar to that of a cat's eyes, because it was the size. He said it had to have been at least 10 feet off the ground, between him and this thing. He'd been there for only about an hour, and he never noticed these eyes before. He couldn't really see any shape behind the eye, but in a spot where there's likely no perch to have a bird, it was just staying there, without moving. He said it was on the same side as the tree as the game trail, where earlier he saw the big hairy biped walking. He had no desire to make eye contact for very long, so he turned his back on this red eye and went back to making dinner. He said he wanted to exit the situation and did not want to stare into these eyes in case it was trying to communicate with him. He heard a low rumbling growl from behind him. Something hit his tent, then left. He said it hit the tent hard enough to shake it, and he heard footsteps, like something running away fast. He knew at this point it wasn't a bear, or any other normal animal in the woods, because had they been doing this, he would have known exactly what they were. He somehow stayed calm and remained as calm as he could. He said he had a hard time falling asleep, but when he finally fell asleep, he was awakened by the thing growling, grunting, and making a deep rattling noise, like it had a cold. And he said you could smell it too. He described it as a fecal, sweaty, rotten cheese skunk smell. It was terrible. When he reflects back on this, he believes this thing got more and more aggressive gradually because it would not leave its territory. But he's uncertain. because at the time, he didn't feel any fear of this big hairy biped, only that it was angry. It woke him up at about 2:30 in the morning, and he said it left again, making the noise, and after that, he never saw or heard it again. Once daylight came, he went to check out the area where he saw it the night previous. He said there were two different trails in the area, and they intersected at the spot where he saw the two red eyes the night before. He said it was the same side where he found the dead deer, which was now missing, the dead doe carcass. He said the trail was similar to that of a game trail, but it looked more like a person had cleared it, which was probably not possible since he was kind of way out there. And this is when he was able to get a more accurate measure of where the eyes were on the tree. He said it was easily probably about 10 feet up, means whatever was watching him was standing right behind the large tree. He had zero desire to meet whatever this was at that point, so he decided enough was enough and to pack his things and leave. He said that he was not a believer before the encounter, but now he definitely is. He doesn't see any way that it could have been a hoax or a mistake or a misidentification. Remember, he's been in the woods a long time and has spent much time in the outdoors. He's anybody who should have a respectable opinion and enough to know that he's an expert. And now that he's getting a little older, he doesn't go into the woods as much anymore, and also retired as a park ranger for the time being. I've worked at this job at this national park for now more than 20 years. I've seen a lot of strange things on the job, but this sighting is easily the strangest. I'm not sure what to make of it. The only thing I'm certain of is that I was not dreaming or imagining this. I am absolutely certain of that. I'm sure most people would think I'm crazy if I told them, but I know what I saw and I know what I heard. I want somebody to talk to about this for a long time. You see, my wife, she just simply doesn't understand. I mean, I guess I can't blame her. She thinks I'm nuts. She's never really been one to be into the outdoors, so she thinks I should go into law enforcement or something. And totally off-rights the fact that I'm a ranger. I like being outside, though. It being with the animals and protecting the environment. I've got no interest in being a government worker who hunts down bad guys. I've had this job for a long time. I like the work and the area that I work in. There's just something about being outdoors that has always appealed to me. I was raised in the deserts of the Southwest, and I always enjoyed the climate. My wife and I, however, ended up divorcing soon after this. When we were married, though, she had a brother who was also a petroleum engineer, and his job took him through some pretty remote areas of the world. The places he went were breathtaking and rugged, and I had an interest in going with him on some field trips. But because I had this job, I couldn't just leave and disappear for weeks on end. Anyway, even though we've been divorced for a while now, we still remain somewhat good friends. And we've been divorced for almost a decade now. But ever since his divorce, he and his new wife Angela get together with me and my girlfriend Lori a couple times a year, and we go camping. Since I'm a ranger, I'm also their trail guide, and guide them into the far reaches of the backcountry, where I tell them stories and show them things about nature they never knew. He and Angela love the Palo Duro Canyon, and so does Lori, so we pretty much spend every camping trip together at that same place. Most couples who camp tend to stay near sources of water, so we do too. Our camp is always a couple of miles from water, not so near that you would get wet in the rain, but not so distant that it would take an entire day to hike to the nearest water source. One evening, I was camped out by myself. My buddies had to work, and so Lori and I decided to camp at this place, and I have at the other end of Palo Duro, just inside the state lines. I had scouted out this campsite from the nearby interstate before we made the drive. I knew it was perfect. It's a rounded clearing about a quarter mile in diameter, and a little more than a quarter mile north of the interstate. The place is a happy medium between too far away and too much hassle of water to reach. Some of the Native American people here have mentioned encounters with Bigfoots when I would chat with them, so I'm pretty certain these creatures come from the area and canyon. We also both love Ancient Aliens on the show History Channel, and we have a talk about legends over the years. Some of them believe that it's just a bunch of hooey, and there are not enough sighting reports or documented evidence to fully have substantial beliefs in this creature. Anyway, the campsite I was at an area between this rock formation that had a bunch of small caves, and the steepest part of the ridge where you could hike up the thing and possibly spot anything wandering in the canyon below. Right by the place where I think that I pitched my tent, there's an old corral made of rocks where I think that people used to raise sheep and cattle, or mostly cattle. There's also what looks to be like a cistern, but I can't imagine that this is still functional, and someone would take that much time and effort to build something and put it all the way up there. Whatever it is now is essentially a dry rock pond, but there are piles of old empty water bottles from people all over the country who hike and camp there and leave the trash. So this evening, I was cooking a nice big steak to celebrate my birthday, and steak was not something we were almost ever able to cook at the canyon, because we could not find a place to safely make a fire. As I'm cooking the steak, I start to smell something foul. All I can tell you is that it smelled like a dirty wet dog mixed with garbage. I tried to sniff it out, but I couldn't exactly tell you where the smell was coming from, so I figured it was maybe a dead skunk or something. I mean, I don't know what the smell was, but I know what it wasn't. I've been told about the smell before, and I could tell you what I smelled was not anything normal. I've heard that smell described as a wet dog and running garbage, but it could also be something else. I looked around, but I just couldn't see anything. So I went back to cooking my steak, and I left the brush burning in the fire. I kind of just forgot about the smell for a while. It was a warm night, and I was happy to be out there. That's when I started hearing crashing in the canyon below, moving its way up to the brush behind me. I thought it might be a deer or possibly a coyote. I kept an eye on the brush, but wasn't paying as much attention to it as I probably should have. I was enjoying the night, or at least trying to, enjoying my steak and thinking about the fun we would have the next day. Then, I put my steak down and took my flashlight, began shining it around the perimeter of the camp, hoping to see a deer or coyote, and thinking about how we'd get a picture of one of these creatures. I thought about it more, and I almost wondered, are we being stalked by a Bigfoot? And I started hearing this sound. It was deep, like a low frequency sound, but also kind of like a growl. I thought it was a coyote, but it was deep, and I've never heard a coyote make a sound like that. It was a deep growl that turned into a howl. I heard some more crashing in the brush. I thought I could see something, but then I wasn't so sure. It was just a shadow, if you know what I mean. I couldn't really see anything clear, just enough to know that whatever it was big and black. Now I was feeling terror for the first time. This creature or being was getting closer and making all kinds of nasty noise. It was making these sounds. It was growling and howling, almost kind of like grunting. The creature was very close to my campsite, and I was completely defenseless. All I had was a steak knife. I did not have a gun, and I'm pretty sure it was watching me the entire time. I didn't know that until later, but it was most likely stalking me. I was feeling very afraid. I felt fear before, but never been afraid like this. I was convinced I was going to die. I started to shake, feeling nauseous. I just knew that if I did not get out of there, I was dead. I knew the creature was stalking me, and I knew I was a lot closer to the clearing than I was to the interstate. I didn't know what to do. I began to panic. I was too scared to run, but I also knew that if I just sat there, I was also dead. I knew that I had to do something, but I did not know what. I looked around and I saw the brush I'd gathered to keep the fire going. I began to run, and I could hear the creature running behind me. I didn't know what was going to happen, but I did not know if I would survive. The next thing I knew, I was lying flat on my back. I must have knocked into a tree branch and knocked myself unconscious. I felt this thing approaching. And then I recall some strange gibbering noises. At least, that's what I would call them. It sounded like somebody speaking gibberish in a really high tone of voice, and that same awful wet dog and garbage smell permeating my entire nostrils. After that, I completely lost consciousness. When I regained it, it was in the morning, and I awoke with nothing. I didn't know where I was, and after that, it would take me roughly a 2-day hike to get back to the interstate. To make a long story short, somehow, some way, after I lost consciousness, I was somehow transported miles and miles away from the spot that I'd hit the branch and lost consciousness originally. Something or someone transported, or I assumed carried me, because that stink was all over my body and all around where I woke up. Where I regained consciousness the second time was in a small clearing and some brush. There were bones and stink scattered all around, so part of me almost wonders if it had taken me to its den, although it wasn't anywhere around, but could it be possible it was planning on killing me or eating me? I'm not sure. I'm sorry if this was hard to read, but I did my best to put my thoughts down to paper, and this has easily been an encounter or an experience that has left me frightened and scared to fully fulfill my job. I was a park ranger in northern Minnesota's Voyageurs National Park. It was a beautiful night, calm and warm. We had just finished a workday, and I was sitting with a coworker on a dock. We were looking up at the stars and talking about life, when all of a sudden, a howl came out of the woods. Now, I know what a wolf's howl sounds like, and this was nothing like that. It was far more distorted, more powerful, like whatever it came from had a massive set of lungs. It was unlike any howl I had ever heard before, extremely loud and very long, lasting roughly 18 seconds. It started very low in pitch and ended with a higher pitched howl. It was one long howl with no breaks or pauses. It appeared to be coming from the south, from the woods. It was very close. We ran inside to grab our guns and lights. We decided to go in the woods and try and find the source, but we could not find anything. We heard it again, this time coming from the east. We ran back to our camping trailer, grabbing our recording equipment, going back into the woods yet again. We set up the microphones and started recording sounds. We got the sound a total of 4 times. We ran back to the office to play the sounds back. As we listened, we could hear something in the background. After we enhanced the sound, this is what we found. As the howl began, it was as if something was growling very loudly. And then as the howl went on, the howl changed, almost in timbre, and it seemed to be getting closer. After the howl ended, there was another sound, a howl coming from the other side of the lake. It was a call and response. 2 things were talking to each other, 2 large wolves. Even though it was barely audible from the recording, it was there. We listened to these over and over. We were very excited about what we had found, but we're going to post on our website and talk about the incident over the radio. Our supervisor shut the whole thing down. I never seen him so serious and angry. He told us we could never talk about this incident again, and if we ever did, then we would be fired. We never talked about that night again, and have since got rid of the tapes. I've been thinking about that night, though, a lot. It's been haunting me for the past 15 years. I've tried to block out the whole incident and keep myself occupied with the upcoming 2016 election, but I know that's impossible. Even something as controversial as that will not make my mind go off it. I know that there is something out there, something big and dangerous, but also something that makes me very curious. I am a ranger, so I generally know what's in the woods. I've dealt with bears, wolves, and moose, and other animals. I know what they sound like, on an occasion, but this was not a wolf, or at least not a normal one, bear or moose. It was something very large and powerful. It was not natural. That is why I wrote to you. I cannot deal with this alone anymore, and I need somebody to talk to about this. I just hope you will not share this with just anybody, but people or somebody who will listen, who will take me seriously. I cannot reveal my identity, otherwise I will be blacklisted by the U.S. National Park Service, and if they found out I told you this, I could lose my job. I hope you can keep my name from the public. Thanks for listening and have a great day.